everyone. So today I'll be doing a video on the FSUAE Amiga emulator, which you see right here. So I'm gonna go and download this right now. The one that I downloaded was this one right here. If you download this one, it has an installer, and it will install it right onto your computer. However, I like this one. So I downloaded that. What's actually downloading? It's almost done. Okay, great. So I'm gonna open that. I'm gonna call it FSUAE. That's what I'm gonna call the folder, and I'm going to move all the files here. Okay, that's done. Also, you have to get the BIOS files if you want to use this. They have it at Amiga Forever. You could buy any of these packages and get it. It's about $29.95, or you could find the BIOS files on the internet, or you could just buy it here. It doesn't matter. If you don't have it, you just buy it. Now I'm going to start the emulator. Also, you have to get a file called, there's an operating system called Workbench. It also comes with Workbench if you buy this. I think Workbench 1.2, maybe up to 4. For later Amigas, like Amiga 3000 or 4000, comes with everything. All the vital software, that is, which will make an Amiga emulator run. So, let's get started. So this is a launcher, so I'm gonna send it to my desktop. Create a shortcut for it. And I'm gonna put it right here. And I also have it on my desktop as well, so I can launch it from both places if I want. So I'm gonna open it up. Okay, first thing I want to do is I want to export or import the Kickstart ROMs. Go here, import Kickstarts. I put it into this folder. This is where I have my Kickstarts. I'm going to import it. Says there's nothing in there. Okay, this is where it is, not just that. Okay, browse again, BIOS, Kickstarts, select, import. Okay, that's done. So these are the Amiga ROMs that I have. Amiga 500, Amiga 500 Plus, and Amiga 1200. And also Commodore Amiga CD TV. Close that. So I have all the BIOS files. So I'm going to select Amiga 1200. I can select various ones. I'll select this one. As for floppy drives, I want to select multi. have 4 drives, so I don't have to swap discs. So I'm gonna go here and go to floppy to speed. I want to put that at turbo, the fastest. Let's select a controller. So I want to select my Logitech dual action gamepad. For mouse, I just want to select this, the mouse that I'm using now. I want 8 megabytes on it. I want to go to setting here. If you click on here, it shows you the configuration for your controller. So I want to use this button for my joystick. So you can select which button you want. The Amiga joystick only had 1 button, so I want this button to be selected. D-pad is for moving up, down, left, right. Video. Everything looks good here. Advanced video. I didn't change anything here. Okay, that's good. Everything's fine here. So I want to do one more thing. Theme option. I want to download this theme. Save it. This is where the Amiga is at. Let me read what this says. Themes, you gotta put it into the themes folder, so it's not there, so I'll just create it. Just have to unpack everything in there and put it into that folder. Like so. The contents into the themes folder. Okay, so I guess not like that, but like this. Close that. And it says I have to write some kind of script. Copy that. Put that in advance, it says. Settings. Advance. Paste. start a game. Let's try It Came from the Desert. This game is, you could find it on abandonware.com. I'll show you where that is. You could download it for the PC or the Amiga. For me, downloaded for the PC. I mean for the Amiga. This one. It doesn't cost anything. You could just download it there. I'm going to select this one, this two, and this three. And I want to save this configuration. I would call it Amiga 1200. And now I want to start. If you want to exit, it's F12. Just like that. Looks like I kind of like screwed up here. I didn't do something correct. Let me go back to document. That was theme or themes? I'm not sure. There's other variants, but I want this variant. Themes, okay, it's plural. Maybe I have to put the folder in here, I'm not sure. Do that and see if it works. Start again. Okay, now it's working. So I guess you have to put the whole folder in there. So middle mouse button to get your mouse cursor out. I didn't put multiple discs in there. I would have to swap like almost every time, but I don't have to do that. This game just has one button. If you ever played this on the PC, you only use the space bar and the cursors on the keyboard, the arrow cursors, to move, that is.
Okay.
The graphics so much better on the Amiga. The IBM version had Redskin graphics. This doesn't have Redskin graphics. Oh, I pressed the wrong button. That sound is a floppy disk running. It sounds so much better than the PC version or MS-DOS version. So the Amiga 1200 was, I think it was released in 1992. It came with about 2 megabytes of RAM, but you could upgrade it to 8. You could also put a hard drive in there. It didn't come with a hard drive. Okay, that's enough. So you could press F12 and save this state. So I just saved that, press F12, and I could load that if I want to. Press F12 again. So I want to exit the game. Okay. So that's it for that. I'm gonna start another game. This is to eject the discs. So I'm gonna put in another disc. Try another game. Some of these games don't work on Amiga 1200, so you have to switch to an Amiga 500. Let's try Operation Wolf. Here, this time I'm going to do something different called Media Swap List. Put it in there so you could just kind of like switch discs. If you need to switch to disc 2, you could just go here and swap it. I'll show you how to do that. So, start. Wonder if this game works for Amiga 1200. I'm just using the mouse here and pressing the mouse left button to start.
Operation Wolf.
So, this is a mouse game. So telling me to switch disks F12. Press here. And go to, I just press enter and I just press enter again. Click on the mouse. Now change to disk 2. Please insert disk 2. Screwed up here. Let me get out of here. I think I should put both disk 1 and disk 2 in here. So let's start. Okay, now it's working. So I put it in the wrong place. Supposed to put it in DF1. Okay, let's start. The graphics are good, but it really doesn't play that well. It's not really playable. I prefer the MS-DOS version, but it does sound better than the MS-DOS version, I have to say. The programming is not very good. So many frame skips and everything. Even when I'm shooting at somebody, it's like you're not getting hit. It's not registering as a hit. It's off. I can't even shoot that knife. Okay, let me get out of here. Okay, so you saw that demonstration. So to get out, just use the arrow keys and then just go to X and press enter. Just like that. So clear that if you want. Eject. Let's try another game. press down and move to roll. So grenade is the same button that you're shooting from, which is, I think, kind of lame. Okay, that's enough. Let me get out of here. So I'm 12. Okay, that's it. So that's how you run games. So let me run something more. Let me run one last game. So let's say I want to save something. Floppy drive. I think this is a more demanding game. Let's see. Put one. Two. In there. Actually, I'll put them all in there. One. Let's say I want to save this as a game, part of China. Okay, and save it here. All these files are, I'll show you where they are. It's in document here, it's in configuration. So these files here are the same files here. So if you want to delete it, you have to go here and delete it, not from here. You cannot delete it from there. Start. I guess it doesn't work on this computer, so let me get out of here. Let's try a different computer. Let's try an Amiga 500. Just pressing the mouse button to get past each screen. Thank you. This game was meant to be played on a hard drive. Say the PC that or the MS-DOS version was better than this one. Okay, let me get out of here. So for the Amiga 500, you only have two drives. Let's try a different ROM set and see if this game would run. See if I could just play with one. Crashed. Oh well. That's enough. So now you know how to switch discs and stuff like that, so it's pretty simple to use. This is a very simple emulator to use. You can change the graphics card if you want. Try a different game. Try nuclear war. I wonder if this would work on the Amiga 1200. Does, wow. Works. you could just not select it. Let's put it to 0, 0. And let's try playing the game again and see if there's any floppy disk noises. Okay, now you don't hear any floppy disk noises. This theme kind of like gives it a nostalgic feel about it. The monitor, the joystick, the floppy drives, and the notes on the right side. Okay, now you don't hear that, so that's pretty good. So anyways, that's it. So thanks for watching by Ace1000KS, 1975, signing out. So let me get out of here, just exit. So when you exit, everything is deleted, unless you saved it, so that's it.